child some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, oh, that milky white way. Oh, Lord, some of these days. I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to tell my.
My soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness. For his name's sake. Days of my life. And I dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Set me up upon a rock.
And now shall mine head be lifted up round about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice, have mercy also upon me and answer me. And all God's people said amen. Amen. Say amen again. Amen. If God is good to you, say amen again. We've come at this hour, we come at this time, we come at this appointed place to reflect and to celebrate the life of Miss Cynthia Barron. Amen. One who has lived amongst us, one who we have had the opportunity to share life with and to share in this walk. One who, as this family can attest to, was one of the kindest people you ever wanted to meet. And as we're celebrating her life today, our hearts are heavy. But in the midst of this time of celebrating, we know that God is still able, that God can and God will make a way. The family has outlined a program for which we shall use. We'll have prayer of comfort. After that, we'll have our scripture reading, and then we will have a selection from the Porter family. Pray with me now. Gracious and kind God, we come to you. We come to you, O God, with our heads bowed and our hearts filled. Some come with tears. But God, as we come to you, we come realizing and knowing that even now, you are a way maker. And oh God, today as we are praying, we ask that you would look down upon this family, that you would look down upon this son, these brothers, these sisters, oh God, that you would look at them and see them just where they are. Realizing and knowing, oh God, that you know every pain that they're dealing with right now. But God, in the midst of you knowing the pain, we know that you are the only one that can see us through. So God, as we pray to you right now, we pray that you would hold this family together, that you would strengthen them where they're weakened. Oh God, allow them to know that even now, that you have not left them alone. For God, we know that just as you have comforted in the past, we know, God, that you can do it right now. We believe that you can do it right now, for we trust in your word, knowing that you said you would never leave us. And God, we need you right now. We need you to hold hands. We need you to bind those spirits. And then, God, we want to tell you thank you. Thank you, oh God, for this mother and this sister, this aunt, this cousin, this friend who you allowed to be a part of our lives. Thank you, oh God, for allowing her to be everything that she was in this life to us. Now, God, it is our prayer that as we go forth, that you will continue to look upon us, that you will give us the strength that we need as we go from one day to another. We thank you and we praise you for all things. We ask these blessings now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I read you this day, three verses from the 14th chapter of St. John. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would not have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. That where I am, there you may be also. Amen.
Hallelujah.
that you're living this life that you can live again. That you'll be able to lift up your hands and say, I made it over after everything that you've gone through on this side. After struggling on this side, you'll be able to say, I made it over one day. Amen. Amen. We thank God for that song. At this time now, we have a space that's been provided for reflections for those that would like to come and share reflections. We invite you to come at this time. We do ask that, however, you will be mindful of where the family is and what they're going through at this hour. As we share with them, that we come to lift them and encourage them at this time. Those that are going to come, you may come at this time.
Praise the Lord. Amen. I just thank God today for it's an honor for me to say just a few words about Cynthia. Amen. Because I knew her as a friend. I used to see her a lot on my walking journey through Cordele. I'm passing by. I think that I knew just about everybody around Cordele because I was born and raised here. But when I see Cynthia, we never had much conversation with each other, but she would always address me as Uncle Charles. And I think that's because of the majority of this family. They know me as Uncle Charles because of marriage in this family. And it's an honor for me today just to know that when I saw Cynthia, she had that kind of love in her heart and respect no matter what she was doing. See, sometimes a person can forget who they are and who they represent, but she always knew for some reason that when she saw me that I wouldn't mind her calling me Uncle Charles. In fact, about it, I kind of look a blessing and a privilege when somebody can know and respect you that way, because believe me, these days and time, there's very little respect for a lot of people.
Amen.
But I thank God today that I knew Miss Cynthia that way. And she was a lovely, loving person. She had a heart that was, that when I saw her, she gave me the respect. And that I won't ever forget that because, you know, like I say, you hard to get that type of recognition from people these days. But she was a lovely person, and I want family to know that she'll be missing in my heart, because I saw her periodically just about every day until I noticed I didn't see her that much before her sickness. And I had, my wife had told me, said, you know, Cynthia had been down ill for a while. I said, I would have never known it, because every time I saw her, she had a smile on her face. Amen. And she would always say, hey, Uncle Charles, everything's all right? I said, yes, it is. Everything's all right. Good to see you, baby. And we would just go from there. But I want to leave you with this, that praise God, love is not always what it says. It's what it does. Because you can say you love somebody all day long, but until you show that love like she did when she saw me, that's what really matters.
Amen.
And I thank God for Sister Sam again. She will always be in my heart. And may God bless her and her family.
First of all, my life is a strength. So all y'all been here to the pulpit, Deacon Park and his staff. Cynthia, we always call her Susan. She's always been like a sister to me. her and my brother had a little history together, and she pretty much was the only sister all I ever had. It looked like it would have been the only one I ever gonna have, you know? But, I'm just choked up a little bit right now. But she was a beautiful person. She ain't never say no harsh words to nobody. Everything. And KB, she came from a loving family. KB, and he my cousin too. And man, I'm just a little choked up, but I just want to tell the family, man. Y'all already know I've been around all these years. I'm not gonna ever leave. But Susie, she truly gonna be missed. That was a beautiful person. Really, you know. So well, I'm just a little choked up. I'm gonna sit down now because. But I just want to say to the family, I'm still gonna always be here. You know, yeah. I love all y'all. Thank you.
Just like to say that Susie was my cousin, but because of the kind of person she was, I looked at him more like an aunt than a cousin, because that's just how much love she had for people. They were so good to us, her, Aunt Louise, and Linda, growing up, you know, we were welcome any time or any day, any time of night, you know, we were welcome. Whatever they had, we were welcome to it. It could have been 10 people around, and they only had this much, but even if it was 10 people, if they only had 3 pieces of bread, they were going to get some of it. Finding in our hearts and be closer and love each other, because we just need to be closer. And I'm just gonna miss her. I just can't, you know. I accept it, but you know it's hard. And I just hope that we can all come together more often and be more loving like Susie was. That's all I want to say.
I just want to say, God, I thank you for this day. I just thank you so much. I'm so grateful to have a cousin like that, y'all. Whenever she had a situation going on, she would always call me. And when she came out the hospital, I went and sat with her for hours while she laid in the bed, and she was trying to get up and talk to me, but somehow, you know, whatever God will is it gonna be. She told me she was tired, and I didn't accept that, so I immediately went and started to pray. And when Quita called me, She told me she was in the hospital. So I hurry up and I rushed and put my clothes on. I just throwed on anything and went to the hospital. And I went in the room where she was. And, you know, she responded to me. She held my hand. She moved her feet. And I told her, I said, I stayed there for hours. I just couldn't find myself to leave. And when I told her, I said, it was getting late. They didn't want me to, you know, tie her out. So they told me that I had to leave. And I told her before I left, I said, Susan, I said, everything gonna be all right. I said, you gonna fight the good fight. I told her that before she left him. And she nodded her head, she opened her eyes. And she shook her head at me, y'all. That's why I left, because I told her, I said, the next morning, I said, I'll be back. I said, as soon as I put that boy up to school in the morning, I'm coming back wide open. And she looked at me and turned her head. And she nodded her head. When I went back the next morning, and I looked at her, and she was non-responsive. But God knows best. It's time to turn your life over to the Lord. We are going to make mistakes because we're in the flesh. As long as we live in the flesh, we're going to make mistakes. But we have to repent daily. Yes. I have learned that I don't care what nobody say or think about me. I repent for my sins if I do wrong. And I barely try to do anyone wrong. I barely try to do anyone wrong. Because I want to make it in. She had made it in because she was the best cousin. Oh, she was so sweet and humble. She was so sweet and humble. And I'm going to say one more thing. I told her the day before she went to the hospital, she called me. I said, call Nikki. She said, no. She said, no, I'm not going to call him. She said, I'm tired. But I love her so much. I love my family. To all my family, I love y'all. I love y'all. It's time for us to stand. It's time for us to touch and agree with one another. It's time. It's not time to stop playing. It's time to get by God's business.
To say anything, but sometimes when your heart gets so heavy, you just got to say something. And I'm not gonna be comfortable until I say goodbye to Cynthia, Susie, family and friends. I love you, Cynthia. We gonna miss you.
I just thank him for this day. And I'm going to reflect and piggyback on what my auntie said about love and each other and getting it right with each other. Getting it together, because it is time. It's high time. As my mama would say, God rest her soul. I see Susan, and everybody knows, if you don't see nobody, go to Walmart. You will see them there. I see Susan at Walmart, and like she said, smile, humble. humble spirit wouldn't hurt us all. And I'm gonna miss her dearly coming through them Walmart doors. Cause it was the time she was out there that I didn't bump into her. Hey cuz, and smiling just as pretty as you wanna see it.
Amen.
And loving spirit, she had that. That's what we got to do. We got to get that loving spirit, that unconditional love. And forget about what we did to each other yesterday.
Yes. Amen.
5 years ago.
All right.
10 years ago.
All right.
Let's get it together, people.
Right.
It's time to get it together. And show that unconditional love that God wants us to have for one another.
Amen.
To this family, let's stretch out our loving arms. And I know we have that. I know we have that in our hearts. Grandma left us with some love in our heart.
Yes, yes.
Grandma got it in her heart. Grandma,
yes,
me.
Yes,
yes, yes, sir. Like she said, I don't care what it is that she had. We was able to get some of it. They was able to share it. We got to learn how to love and share and just embrace one another. Regardless of the situation.
I know God is good.
So y'all just look up. Look to the hill from which comes your help. All of it comes from the Lord. Ain't none of us perfect. We make mistakes. We fall down. We got to, like you said, repent and go on with your life.
No,
let family be strong in the Lord and in the power of His
word. No, I don't hate nobody. I love all of my people. Oh, yes, sir. I do. So we'll be 94 years old.
My sister married into the family around the mayor came in. And when I tell you, I love all y'all. I love y'all. My brother-in-law, my sister couldn't have married nobody better than my brother-in-law. You hear me? I love my brother-in-law, baby. My sister's so serious. My brother-in-law, good God. My brother-in-law has to go through some stuff. And I'm just keeping it real, y'all. But I know he loves that good. You hear me? That's a man love a woman now. I love him. He know I love him. Thor, all of y'all know I love y'all. Susie was a beautiful spirit, young lady. You hear me? And I don't think Mike Dunn been the same since her service was there. Because she was a beautiful person. And she's going to be missed. But we have to understand that, you know, God doesn't make any mistakes. And her time was up with us. So just look around. Look around. Love on them while they're here. Love on them while they're here. Because when you're laying out there, they can't hear you. They can't hear you no more. It's a done deal. So while the breath is still in your body and you can hear and hug and love on your people. Love on them. Love on them.
Understanding that the story I tell might not be the story that you will tell, but we all have a story that we'll tell. And to be able to tell the story that we made it over, sometimes we had to cry, but we made it over. Sometimes we had to struggle, but we made it over. Sometimes we had to go and be by ourselves, but we made it over. It's a story that we can tell. We thank God for each of you who are here as we celebrate Cynthia's life. We give honor to God for our being here, to Elder Wilson, Minister Holmes, other ministers that might be present, and to this family. Amen. We thank God for you, and we pray that God will continue to look down upon you in this time of grief. There's a passage of scripture found in the book of Ecclesiastes. Very familiar passage of scripture that we've all read it, said it, recited it. To everything, there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven. For just a few minutes, we want to share with you from the thought, how much time do you really have? How much time do you really have? On Saturday, October the 24th, 6 months ago, I stood in the same spot with the same family. And we came at that point because we were celebrating the life of Ms. Louise. And here we are, 6 months and one day later. Time has caused us to come back to the same spot. What has happened from that time to this time? If you will allow me just to share with you what you have already shared as a family. We talked about that we need to love better. Amen. We talked about that we need to show kindness towards one another. We talked about how we as a family need to be there for one another. But then we also said, someone said, that we already know how to do these things. So why won't we do them? So I asked you, how much time do you really have? See, because days still have 24 hours in them. But the thing that comes to us when we talk about time is that many of us don't think, or many of us feel, that we have more time than we really do. See, we think that time in itself is going to wait on us. But time will not wait on us. There's a phrase that we often say, time catches up with you. Time is there when you get up in the morning. Time is there when you go to sleep at night. And even while you're sleeping, time is still doing what time does. So how much time do you really have? And what is it about time that we think we have so much of it that we want to treat it any kind of way? See, because when you really value time, time will tell you that I might not see you tomorrow, so I need to tell you today how I feel about you. Time will tell you that we don't have as much time as we had 6 months ago. Because, see, think about it. 6 months ago, there were those of us who were here as we celebrated Miss Louise's life, and we made promises to one another that we're going to treat each other better, that we're going to call each other, that we're going to drop by, we're going to see each other, we're going to do this and we're going to do that. But then time has caught up with us, and we have not followed through on those promises. We don't have the time that we think we have. I'm glad that, if you remember at Ms. Louise Fielder, I shared with you how we grew up, Cynthia and all of us, we grew up in the same area. Yeah, I remember over there on Bass Street, you know, that's where we grew up at, in the projects. That's where we grew up at. And how we valued what we had even though we didn't have a lot. But as time grew on, we became separated. We didn't see each other. We didn't see each other as much. But then God gave us another chance. That's what time does. See, because the controller of time knows what he's doing, and he knows how to manage his time, but whether we manage ours is the problem. So I remember shortly after Miss Louise's funeral, Cynthia and I had a conversation. And she said to me, she said, as I sure didn't remember that you remembered all that stuff that you talked about at Mama's funeral. I could not believe that you remembered all those things. And as we talked about it, we began to laugh and to think about how we lived in a time where we did not care what was going on around us. We were children. When it came time to eat, we didn't know that there was somebody who was struggling to put something on the table for us to eat. Okay. We were growing up at a time, and we didn't understand that even though we let the fan stay on all night long, there was somebody that wanted to cut the fan off because they were the one paying the bills. We didn't understand that while we were sitting up there eating up everything that was around us, that somebody was struggling, wondering how they were going to feed us the next week or the next day. But we were just living in a time that we thought belonged to us. Amen. But what you have to understand, we don't have the time now to treat folk any kind of way. We don't have time to be living as if we are just here for a little while and we can do whatever we want to do and everything will be all right when it's over, because there are some requirements to living this life. You got to learn how to treat folk. You got to learn how to talk to folk. You got to learn how to be there for folk when need. See, it's all right to say that we can, but where are you when I need my kin? It's all right to say that if you need me, call me, but when I call you, you look at it and don't answer the phone. It sounds good when you're standing in a crowd of people to say all those things, but what happens when the time comes and that's what you got to do? What time do you have? And see, it's important that we understand this. Somebody said it earlier that the service at McDonald's wasn't quite the same after Cynthia left. Because she knew how to treat folks. When they walked in there, she knew how to treat them. She knew I wanted sweet tea with lemon. And when they didn't have no lemon, she shake her head and say, no lemon. She knew those things because she valued what life had given her. But then there was something else about her that you've all touched upon. But she was the best at being who she was. Through her mother's sickness, she was right there. She never wavered. Although there were days she didn't feel good herself, she never wavered. And then as a mother, you are one fortunate young man. Amen. Because you had an example of how to treat folk. Yes, Lord. And I remember talking to you on the telephone the other day, you were still that same little humble kid that was always looking for something else to eat. But your mama left you with something. She left you with that. And there, that's a part of you that you will forever have, because she understood that the day would come and she wasn't going to be here. But her prayers were answered, because she had a chance to see you live to be able to take care of yourself. And that was her prayer. That was what she wanted, that you would be able to take care of yourself. As her brothers, y'all got to step up. Not because I'm saying that in a bad way, because I remember I used to beat folk up over on Bad Street, so I want y'all to jump on. But y'all got to step up and fill that gap, that void. Because, see, Cynthia was the one that kept everything together. She was the one that was going to call and make sure y'all were doing what y'all was supposed to do. She was going to be the one that was going to ask those questions. She was going to be that one. Who is it now? What time do you have now? Time. And see, then Cynthia was the one that no matter what her brothers, cousins, nieces, nephews did, you weren't going to come to her and talk bad about her.
Amen.
So what time do you have? Are you taking advantage of the time that you have now? See, it would be easy for me to stand up here and say that, oh, just keep living. We'll see it. We'll talk about it next week. We'll plan when we have the family reunion. We'll make plans to do better towards one another then. But see, what we fail to realize that these funeral services have become our makeshift family reunions. Because we don't get to see our family the way we used to see them. And some of us don't want to see our family. But when you come to realize all we got is each other, and we got to learn how to treat each other better. So ask yourself, how much time do you really have? What are you going to do with the time that you have left? Leaving here today as a family. And I say as a family because I consider myself to be a part of this family. Don't leave here without finding somebody in your family that you have not seen in a while and making sure that they know that you love them. See, it's easy to stand up here and say, I love y'all. But I want you to look somebody in the eye and tell them that. Look them in the eye and tell them that. Because, see, when you can express love and show love to somebody, that kills all that other stuff that's going on in between. All that animosity and all that hate that's in there. See, that separates that because you have overcome the very thing that you thought was going to keep you apart. So how much time do you really have? Are you taking advantage of the time that you have? See, we'll get up in the morning, and we'll go about our day, and we'll never take time to tell God thank you for waking us up. Amen. We'll come to the end of the day, we'll get ready to go to bed, and we'll get in our beds, and we'll go to sleep, and we will never have taken the time to say, Lord, I thank you for keeping me throughout this day. We'll get right back up in the morning and do the same thing again, and we will never acknowledge the fact that it was the Lord who took us to the job. It was the Lord that allowed us to make it to the grocery store. It was the Lord that kept us when that car could have hit us, but it didn't hit us. It was the Lord that blocked all those things that would come. It was the Lord that kept us. So how much time do you have? How much time do you really have? See, Susie lived her life, and she lived it in a way that we all were affected by her kindness, her way, her position, her disposition of treating people a certain way. So what about her life has influenced your life? What about her life will cause you to change the way you're living? Take advantage of the time that you have. And then while you're taking advantage of the time, my final thought with you is this. Ask God to see you for who you really are.
Amen.
Ask the Lord to look at you. See, because while family might keep up with all the stuff you used to do, he is the one that can take you and he can change your life. He can turn your life around. He can shake you off and he can make you brand new. He can put you to a point where when you wake up in the morning, folk might remember how you used to be, but there'll be something that'll show up in you. The love of God will create something in you that when people see you, they'll be glad to see you coming. They'll know. And see, the thing about a change is you don't have to announce it to anybody. You don't have to announce your change. You just have to live your change. And when you're living the change, people will see the change. And when people see the change, then they'll know that it's a change that has come directly from God. Because see, all of us can act holy. But there's a difference when that change has come from the inside. Because it'll show up on the outside. So how much time do you have? Are you really taking advantage of the time that you have? As we reflect upon Cynthia's life, thank God that she came this way. Thank God that she was who she was. Thank God that she loved in spite of. And thank God that her life is an example that somebody can know that they can live better. Eternal God, our Father, we thank you now for this day. And God, we thank you for the time that you've given us. Help us, oh God, to take advantage of this time that you've given us to live better, to love better, and to treat others better. Help us, oh God, to walk as you would have us to walk. And then God, as we thank you for this day, we thank you, oh God, for allowing this woman to pass this way. This mother, this sister, this aunt, this niece, this cousin, this friend. Thank you, oh God, that her life and her living has not been in vain. We thank you now for all things, and we ask all these blessings. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Prepare for our committal. For as much as it has pleased you. the Almighty God and his wise providence to take out of this world the soul of our deceased sister, Miss Cynthia Ann Barron. We therefore commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection and the last day of the life of the world to come through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose second coming in glorious majesty to judge the world, the earth, and the sea shall give up their dead, and the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made like unto his own glorious body, according to the mighty working whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, from henceforth blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Even so saith the Spirit, for they rest from their labors. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Father, again we thank you for this day. And God, we thank you for your love. It is our prayer that you will continue to shower your blessings down upon us. Continue to hold this family. Continue to keep them as they go from one day to another. We ask these blessings now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our benediction. Now may the grace of God, the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, rest, rule, and abide with each of us, now, henceforth, and forevermore. Together, all the people of God said, amen. 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 Amen.